from that thing?
In this region. They really worship the trees, the river spirits, the spirits of wells. And for many people, they had to really adapt to the Roman system. So what they often did in temples devoted to Diana Artemis, who was also the goddess of the wild places, they created space for people to also venerate the old gods, the god of the springs, of the rivers, of the trees. They were all given a place within, like, the Roman pantheon. So in that way, the Roman pantheon, just like the Christian church later, absorbed the local religions and the local beliefs and the local spirits into their own structure. So for me, it was very interesting to visit these temples because it tells you a lot more about also what were the local beliefs from before the Romans or the Greeks came into the area. Also, the goddess Artemis herself, or Diana, is also the leader of several egregores, but these are not egregores of humans, but egregores of nature spirits.
Oh, well.
Because these nature spirits also have an evolutionary path. So all the storms, the trees, the animals, they also have their way of growing, and also their idea of how they want to change the world, which is a good world. And through the guidance of Diana, they're also working on it. But since humankind has claimed dominion over large parts of the earth, the nature egregores are shrinking or becoming less and less relevant because they have less coordination, less power, less knowledge to build things up. But as one of the kind of counterpoints, you get nature spirits try to incarnate in human bodies, also to try to create a kind of a link between the two. One of the big examples of this are the expressionist painters in France. And, they spent a lot of time in southern France. And many of them, if you look at them energetically, they don't have the normal second chakra system, but they have a very different chakra system, which is actually identical to the chakra system in nature spirits. They're actually nature spirits incarnating in bodies to give people again, like, okay, what is nature like? How is, can you experience it? What is the energy of nature?
Rousseau.
In a way, reconnect.
And what does the chakra system look like?
It's very different. It's like, for instance, clients tend to have two chakras.
What?
They tend to have two heart chakras instead of one.
Okay.
So they're often, in some areas they're more simple, in other areas they're more advanced. So they can teach us something about, especially water spirits, they're very good at connecting, communication, and this is also why the two heart chakras, they can do, like, do that very well. Earth spirits, air spirits. Basically all the elements are also translated downwards a little bit into nature spirits. So they're close to elemental spirits, but already more evolved than elemental spirits. So the way by bringing sacrifices here, people were sacrificing on the one hand to have a good hunt or not that the wolf eat their sheep or other things like this. So they were making, in a way, offerings also from the ego level, but much more strongly, there were also many people who, in a way, venerated nature, who came to these places, and by offering things here, they were giving power back to nature, hoping that nature would also heal them. So often these places were also places of magic, of mysteries, working with kinds of natural powers, natural spirits, pleasing them and putting together the communication. And even to this day, I feel that there are a lot of nature spirits available. So if you spend your time looking around, you can see satyrs, you can see nymphs, you can see dryads, you see undines.
I don't see them.
Yeah, I think there's, if I look around a bit, I think there's about at least 20 different types of nature spirits. Just hanging around, because this is a place where they're used to people, talking with them, working with them. This is one of the best preserved places of this nature I've clever accountant, so I hope you'll enjoy it.
Yeah.